despite being born almost 4 months prematurely, a set of identical twins from Derbyshire have accomplished something quite incredible. Born at a scant 500 grams, Harry and Harley Crane were tiny babies. The gestational age at which a fetus is deemed medically viable is over 7 days away. Their length was just 15 centimeters, which is equivalent to a candy bar. Jade, their mother, went into labor at a very early stage of her pregnancy, just 22 weeks and 5 days, and the doctors first diagnosed a miscarriage. In addition, they forewarned her that her two infants were extremely vulnerable, but 39-year-old Jade gushed over the experience in an interview with Sunday Mirror. She went on to say that the room turned into a frenzy and that they began administering life-saving therapy the second Harley cried out. It was the same with Harry. Once it was certain the baby wouldn't make it, she stayed motionless for an hour without anyone checking on him. Jade was frightened despite the fact that it felt great to hear their screams. Due on February 24, twins Harry and Harley are about to be discharged from the neonatal critical care unit at Nottingham's Queen's Medical Center. They have spent over 110 days there, and they currently weigh about 5 pounds. Between the two of them, they've endured 6 surgeries while fighting off infections and chronic lung diseases. Having said that, they are now as long as Steve's finger. They have now grown to a size of 30 centimeters, doubling in size at the age of 52. As far as the UK is concerned, they are the most premature twins ever delivered and to survive. The rapid response of the medical personnel has left them astounded at the twins' resilience in the face of their extremely early arrival. Jade said that the newborns were as small as an ornamental elf. The smallest diapers were made for babies up to 1.5 kg. But her daughter weighed only 500 grams, thus none of them were big enough. My children are little warriors, and I couldn't be more proud of them, she added. The fact that they can endure everything and still manage to smile after it's all over is incredible. They are capable of anything they set their minds to. Jade, who works for the National Health Service, and Steve, who is in sales, were ecstatic to hear Harley cry like a little cat after years of trying to conceive. They underwent 8 IVF rounds and numerous frozen embryo implementations during their 11-year childbearing attempt. The couple nearly went bankrupt paying for these treatments, which totaled £50,000 and were financed by loans and hard work. In addition, they tried naturally for 3 years, during which Jade experienced an ectopic pregnancy. When an egg implants itself outside the uterus, ectopic pregnancies happen. After undergoing IVF, Jade suffered 3 more miscarriages by the end of 2014 and was diagnosed with an overactive immune system that was leading her body to reject conception. Jade, though, has said that the procedure was worthwhile, pointing out that she and her spouse had stored her embryos because they were desperate to start a family and wanted to use them. They then got in touch with a reproductive clinic on London's Harley Street, where Jade was assessed and given medicine to deal with immune system problems. In May 2021, the couple conducted their 8th IVF round and found out that both of the implanted embryos had successfully grown. They were expecting twins, a girl and a boy. During their 9th IVF round, they received the news. Jade says to herself now, "I just couldn't allow myself to believe it. I was so afraid that something more may go wrong, or that I would miscarry. I consequently didn't accomplish much during my pregnancy. I retained the tags on the few items of clothing I did purchase, just in case. You simply don't want to believe in yourself," she told herself. It's better to be safe than sorry. Jade experienced an imminent labor symptom on October 26, 2021, when her membranes burst and she started to leak fluid. This happened 30 hours prior to the 23-week mark. Medical professionals usually wait until the mother has been pregnant for a minimum of 24 weeks before becoming involved in the childbirth process. This cutoff was decreased to 23 weeks, though, because Queen's is a teaching hospital and students needed to get experience with premature babies. Jade's physicians decided to step in. Even though they had first suspected a miscarriage and warned her that she could have to contemplate giving up the twins, Jade finally got to see Harry and Harley when they started to show signs of life. 2 hours after they were transported to the neonatal intensive care unit and put on ventilators, Jade remembers the incident as being horrifying. Jade insisted it couldn't be a miscarriage, even though the doctor had initially labeled it as such since she could feel the kids moving inside of her. Doctors had warned her there was no hope of survival at this point of pregnancy, despite their perilous position. It was extremely challenging for Jade because her illness prevented her from receiving pain medication or adequate monitoring during labor, and the delivery progressed quickly. When Jade asked why she hadn't heard Harley cry, the nurse said it was because Harley was born prematurely. Still, Harley surprised everyone when she let out a cry that sounded like a baby kitten, even though Jade couldn't believe it. An hour later, Harry was born with his amniotic sac still attached. A sign of good fortune in Japan. Considering the doctor's bleak prognosis, Jade was anxious seeing her twins in the newborn intensive care unit, where they were so vulnerable. In their desperation for comfort over their chances of survival, Jade and her partner contacted an American mother who had given birth to twins at 22 weeks. The children are now 4 years old. She helped Jade through those first days by advising her on what to ask the physicians through Instagram, necrotizing enterocolitis. A digestive system disorder, swiftly overcame the parents' initial joy upon receiving the twins' diagnosis. Doctors warned them to brace themselves for the worst, as this is a potentially lethal ailment. We were instructed to gather our relatives and have a christening, Jade recalled. Even though it wasn't a funeral, I insisted on calling it that because it was so terrible. Their perseverance paid off, though. And the twins came dangerously close to becoming the youngest ever to survive being born prematurely. The previous record holder was Jensen and Reuben Powell of Brighton, who were born in 2018 at 22 weeks and 6 days. Jade and Steve eagerly anticipated the arrival of their daughter and son, for whom they had waited a whole month, and are now getting ready to welcome them home. Our goal is for them to return around my original due date, Jade stated. There's no precedence because 22 weeks pregnancies are so uncommon. Normally, doctors would look to other kids born at the same stage for guidance. It was fortunate I chose to go to Queens rather than my local hospital. It's like a lottery, Jade reflected on her experience. I might not have been able to bring my babies home if I had gone there. This decision, she went on to say, was pivotal to their future, head nurse in an interview with The Mirror. Cheryl Griffith and expert Chantel Tomlinson expressed their joy at being able to give Harley and Harry essential neonatal care and assist their parents, Jade and Steve, on their journey. Jade worried that the twins would still need oxygen at home and encounter problems long after they left the hospital, but she finished with conviction, saying, "But there's one more thing I want to say about it. Their incredible adventure will undoubtedly go down in medical history as a watershed moment. I am certain that one day a ward will be named after them." Extremely early deliveries, which are defined as those that take place more than 3 weeks prior to the baby's anticipated due date, usually before the beginning of the 37th week of pregnancy, might pose a number of risks. Prematurity symptoms can vary from mild to severe and include issues with feeding owing to underdeveloped reflexes for sucking and swallowing, low body temperature, distinctive features caused by a lack of fat stores, fine hair covering the body, small size, and an abnormally large head. Extended hospital stays in specialist nursery units, such as neonatal intensive care units or intermediate care nurseries, are typical after premature birth. Essential support will be given by a group of medical professionals with training in neonatal care, who will answer any queries and customize care plans according to the baby's requirements. After watching the first story above, do you have any thoughts? Feel free to share your opinions in the comments section. Now, let's watch another similar story. The 26-year-old Helen broke the global record for most kids delivered in a single birth in an interview to ABC News while holding her newborn son Mohammed. "I am incredibly happy," she says. On May 5, 2021, Helen welcomed her second child, a daughter, to the world. According to Dr. Ali, the clinic director, all the children are doing well. In 2009, at a clinic in Casablanca, Morocco, Nadia Suleiman set a record with 8 babies. Helen broke it. According to updates made 5 months ago, the preemies are doing great and will soon be able to go back to Mali. "They're all getting along extremely well and are a joy to care for," Helen said from a Moroccan hospital. "They're getting stronger every day, so hopefully they can leave the hospital soon." Her husband, a 35-year-old sailor in the Mali Navy, was only able to see the babies for the first time on the July 9th in Morocco due to travel restrictions. The boys' names are Mohammed, Ba, John, and Max, and the girls' names are Ella, Adam, Alice, Eva, and Cindy. "All of them are doing very well and are a delight to care for," Helen said in an interview, expressing her happiness after gaining global recognition during her birth at the Bourjac Clinic in Casablanca. "Their strength is steadily increasing, and we are eagerly anticipating the day when they can be discharged from the hospital and returned home. Intensive care was necessary for the first several months after the birth of each of Helen's 9 infants, who weighed 500 grams to 1 kilogram. Initially, a team of doctors and nurses at the clinic's intensive care unit cared for the 9 infants around the clock. Still, as they near their 6-month mark, they've all put on weight and are doing great, getting ready to go back to Mali, where they were born, in honor of the occasion. Helen and her 35-year-old partner Cater shared some touching new family photos. Adam, Eva, Ella, Cindy, and Alice are depicted as wearing a combination of baby blue and pink garments, while the boys Max, John, Ba, and Mohammed are clad in green rompers bearing the word brother from the photo, approximately 2,600 miles from Casablanca, in the capital of Mali, Bamako. The Cater family's safe transfer was arranged last week during a visit by the country's health minister, Jamanda Tsari. The family has been residing in a flat near the hospital since early August, after being taken out of incubators for ongoing supervision by the medical team. At one point, Helen was handling a tremendous amount of work, using 6 liters of milk and as many as 100 diapers every day, because she was too tired to do it all on her own in July. She stayed home and watched TV most of the day, but her vigor is returning to her now. I can't even begin to fathom the difficulty of caring for one child, much less 9. Their care needs are enormous, Helen said, thanking the medical staff for their hard work and the Mali government for its assistance. Helen stayed at their Timbuktu, Mali house at first, but she delivered the baby's cesarean section under the help of her sister Aisha. Helen related her birth experience, remembering, "Thousands of questions tore across my brain when the infants were born. Essentially conscious of what was happening, I felt as though I was endlessly producing newborns. My sister grasped my hand, but my mind was focused on how to look after them and who could help me." Originally hampered by travel constraints, Cater was unable to participate until the July 9th, following 10 days of quarantine upon arrival in Morocco, mostly funded by the Mali government. The medical bills have almost come to £1 million. Helen almost lost her life from extreme blood loss after birth. Doctors calculated that her babies and amniotic fluid weighed almost 30 kilograms. "For us, being a family is the greatest blessings. We constantly thank God," Cater said. "We are all safe and well cared for. Most importantly, married in 2017, the pair also have a second daughter, Sally, 2.5 years old, who is presently under family care." Acknowledging the financial difficulties ahead with their growing family, Cater, a Malian Navy sailor, realized they needed to enlarge their meager 3-bedroom house. "We try to remain positive even though there are many concerns," he stated. "Our main priorities are looking after our children and getting ready for their homecoming. Right now, having full-time care is quite a boon. It has been consoling to know that well-wishers all around have given them overwhelmingly support. We feel lucky," Cater said, originally expecting 7 children, each with less than a 50% chance of life. Helen overcame the odds, thanks to the intervention of former transitional president. She stayed 2 weeks in hospital in Bamako, Mali, before moving to Morocco. One of the newborns, Ba, pays homage to the Moroccan king, while another is called Mohammed. "I am an only child while Cater has 8 siblings," Helen said. "We see this as Allah's compassion. Nothing in our family history could explain this except His grace. These kids are a gift from Him." 7 days after birth, babies' names were declared in accordance with Islamic custom. 9 babies were delivered in Mali at the same time, an unprecedented event that at first sparked questions about possible fraud. The family recently celebrated their first birthday, and they are in wonderful health. They intend to visit Timbuktu again shortly. 8 Malian couples gave birth to 9 on May 4, 2021, making history and breaking the Guinness World Record for the most live births ever. Because of their mother Helen's high-risk pregnancy, the babies, 4 boys, Max, John, Ba, and Mohammed, 4, and 5 girls, Adam, Eva, Ella, Cindy, and Alice, were born by cesarean section early. At barely 30 weeks of gestation, all 9 of the babies celebrated their first birthdays in Casablanca, Morocco, where they were born, despite worries and a protracted stay in incubators for some. Noting their developmental milestones, such as crawling and first steps, their father, Cater, talked about the difficulties of raising 9 kids. Cater and his 3-year-old daughter Sally were split up for 6 months while Helen was receiving special care in Casablanca, but but they eventually got back together in Morocco, before the family returns to Mali. Cater, a sailor in the Malian army, intends to stay in Casablanca for a few more weeks, however, a precise date has not yet been determined. The Malian government sent representatives to Morocco prior to the delivery to facilitate support, which included medical attention and remote aid. The family is still under the care of the private Borja clinic in Casablanca, which operates out of a specially designed apartment. Considering the difficulty of caring for 9 newborns who in their first year of life suffered common infant ailments like bronchiolitis and bronchitis, Dr. Khalid Massif, who has been monitoring the infants since birth, emphasized the continuous assistance given by nurses. Still, everything has gone rather well overall, with very few health problems. After a year, we are ecstatic to see them all together and in good condition. The children's health and well-being were facilitated by numerous medical specialists in Mali and Morocco, the Malian government, and King Mohammed VI of Morocco, who allowed the mother to be sent to the kingdom during the COVID-19 pandemic. After watching the stories above, do you have any thoughts? Feel free to share your opinions in the comments section. If you enjoyed our video, please like, subscribe, and share our channel. That's all about today's stories. See you next time.